أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه كبر على المشركين ما تدعوهم إليه الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء ويهدي إليه من ينيب وما تفرقوا إلا من بعد ما جاءهم العلم بغيا بينهم ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك إلى أجل مسمى لقضي بينهم وإن الذين أورثوا الكتاب من بعدهم لفي شك منه مريب فلذلك فادع واستقم كما أمرت ولا تتبع أهواءهم وقل آمنت بما أنزل الله من كتاب وأمرت لأعدل بينكم الله ربنا وربكم لنا أعمالنا ولكم أعمالكم لا حجة بيننا وبينكم الله يجمع بيننا وإليه المصير. صدق الله العظيم. We had already read ayah number 13 of Surah Ash-Shura, but let us again translate it, because the two ayat which are coming after that, they three go to make one group. And to understand the coming two ayat, it's necessary to refresh in your mind what we have read in ayah 13. Shara lakum, for you, O followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have ordained min ad-deen, as a deen, ma wassa bihi nuhan, what we ordained to Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam, wallazi awhayna ilayk, and what we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wama wassayna bihi Ibrahim wa Musa wa Isa, and what we enjoined upon Ibrahim and Musa and Isa, an aqimu ad-deen, so that you establish this deen, wala tatafarraqu fihi, and don't be divided regarding this deen and iqamatul deen. As for those whom you are calling, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, regarding the ummiyin, the mushrikeen of Arab, kabura ala al-mushrikeen ma tad'uhum ilayhi. It's very hard, very harsh for them to accept what you are calling them. Ma tad'uhum ilayhi. Allahu yajtabi ilayhi man yasha. But Allah will, you know, He will choose and pull towards Him whomsoever He likes. وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيب. And He will definitely guide towards Him whosoever wishes to be guided. As for the other group, the people of the book, وَمَا تَفَرَّقُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءُوا الْعِلْمُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. Don't hope that they will accept you. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the idea that these people were ignorant. They never knew any Sharia, any Nabi, any Rasul. But you know, these Jews, these Christians, they know Torah, they know Injil, they know all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they say they believe in Allah, and at least, you know, at the face of it, at least the Jews, you know, they are monotheists. They are muwahidun. They are not mushrik at all. And even the Christians, you know, although they are the worst mushriks, but they say one in three or three in one. This is Trinity in unity and unity in Trinity. They also claim that we believe in one God. These are the three aspects of the same Godhead. So there was hope that these people might join and come and respond and accept this deen. But Allah says, no. Don't entertain any such hopes, O Muhammad. Because وَمَا تَفَرَّقُوا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاهُمُ الْعِلْمُ. They have differed from each other bitterly after the knowledge had come to them. They believe in the same Old Testament, the Jews and the Christians, the same Old Testament. That is common between them. But they are bitter enemies of each other. So, what is the reason? بَغِيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. You know, this jealousy among human beings and the urge to dominate, as Adler says, that one of the basic instincts in human beings is the urge to dominate. So, why should we accept their creed? It means they will be above us. Why should I accept what Muhammad is calling for? It means I have to follow him then. I will have to obey him. So this jealousy and this urge to dominate is the reason why people reject, although their hearts testify that this is correct. Because in the case of the Jews, at least for their ulama, the learned people among the Jews, Quran says at more than one places, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ. They recognize Muhammad and Quran sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just as they recognize their own sons. But still, they were the worst enemies. Why? Jealousy. بَغْيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. And actually this subject, that all these, you know, schisms in the world and mankind, they are on the basis of this بَغْيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. This subject came in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 213, then Ali Imran, Ayah 19, then now here, and for the fourth time it will come in Surah Al-Jasiyah, Ayah 17. This بَغْيَمْ بَيْنَهُمْ is the root cause. The urge to dominate is the root cause. The jealousy among people is the root cause. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. And had not a word of your Lord passed already for a fixed time of period, period of time, لَقُوْضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ. All matters between them would have been decided. Allah has kept these things for decision for the day of judgment. Otherwise, in this very world, these things would have been decided. وَإِنَّ الَّذِيرَ أُورِسُ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ لَفِي شَكِّمْ مِنْهُ مُرِيبٍ. And verily those who inherited the books after them, the book was given to Musa and Bani Israel, they inherited. The book was given to Jesus and his Hawariyin, they inherited it. But you know, when this, those people who inherit the books, after some time, the fi shakkim minhum urib, they themselves come in doubts about that book. And you know, very disturbing doubts, they surround them. So you, Muhammad, don't hope, neither these mushrikeen, ummiyin, are going to accept you easily, nor there can be an easy acceptance for you from among the people of the book. But فَلَزَالِكَ فَدْعُوا. But you keep on calling for this. Perseverance in calling. Istiqamah ala dawa. This dawa, this call should continue, 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 whether somebody is accepting or not. And we have the example that Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam kept calling people for 950 years. We have read it in Surah Al-Ankabut. وَلَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَرْضُ. Now count here. These are the commandments coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they are the commandments to every da'i, which from among his followers, because this ummah has to go till the end of this world. The Prophet said, أَنَا آخِرُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَأَنْتُمْ آخِرُ الْأُمَمِ. I am the last messenger and you are the last ummah. So we have to continue. So people will be coming. And they will call towards the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, walking in the footsteps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for them also, these are the instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For every da'i of deen. فَلِذَٰلِكَ فَدْعُوا. Number one. You go on calling for this, iqamatu deen. For nothing less. وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ. And you stand and persevere as you have been commanded. You don't swerve due to pressures from this side or that side. These mushrikeen will be pressurizing you, as we saw in Surah Yunus. Ayat bighayr Quran in ghayr hadha wa baddil ho. Muhammad presents some other Quran or make some changes in it. This Quran is too rigid. We can't accept it. And in the same way in Surah Bani Israel, وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ عَنِ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ لِتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَهُ. So pressure would come to you from this side also, from that side also. But فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. Don't follow their wishes and lusts. وَقُلْ and say, آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ. I have total faith in the book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to me. وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Number 5. I have been commanded to establish justice amongst you. This is the most important part of it. That don't think that I am only a sermon giver. No. I have come to establish justice. To do away with all forms of exploitation, all forms of repression, discrimination, injustices, exploitations, and to establish system of justice over here. I come for that. I'm not a storyteller. I'm not a poet. I'm not only a sermon sayer. A wise comes to this locality and he says makes a very good speech, and then he accepts something which is presented to him and goes to the other town. And there again he is speaking it. It is his profession. I am not one of them. Don't take me to be a sermon sayer. أُمِرْتُ لِعَدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. I have been commanded to establish justice between you. اللَّهُ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ. Now as far as your opposition to my mission, Allah is our Lord and your Lord also. لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. For us will be the results of what we are doing. And for you will be the results of what you are doing. La hujjata bainana wa bainakum. There is no use of any argument among us. Why to fight? Allahu yajma'u bainana. Allah will gather us together. Wa ilayhi al-masir. Maybe after some time that we get together, we can say these words to the different movements among the Muslims. They are working for Islam, but the methodologies are different. You know, maybe emphasis is different. Some are more emphasizing on the personal characters. Others emphasize more the political aspect, etc., etc. All are sincere. No, nobody, you know, is dishonest. So if we can say to each other, Allahu Rabbuna wa Rabbukum. Our Lord and your Lord is the same. Lana amaluna wa lakum amalukum. Whatever we are doing, if they are accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we shall get the reward. If rejected, then we shall be the losers. And if what you are doing, the results will come to you. La hujjata bainana wa bainakum. There is no need of fighting between us. Why this argument? Allahu yajma'u bainana. Maybe tomorrow, day after, we come together. We agree on some one program. That's possible. Allahu yajma'u bainana. He might bring us together. Or at least, ilayhi al-masir. One day we shall be standing all before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There we shall be all together. And then everybody should know, will come to know where he stood. What was his position? How much he was correct and how much he was wrong. So no need of argument and no need of fighting. وَالَّذِينَ يُحَاجُّونَ فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا مَسْتُجِيبَ لَهُ. And those, as for those who are arguing concerning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, although his call has been acknowledged by many people, حُجَّتُهُمْ دَاحِذَةٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Their excuse and argument is void with their Lord. وَعَلَيْهِمْ غَضَبٌ. Upon them will come the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ. And for them is the severe chastisement. This concerns those peoples who have seen people making sacrifices for the deen of Allah. You know, in the beginning of every revolutionary movement, because people see, it's a hard task, the society will retort, it will come against you, you'll be in difficulty. When you say your system is wrong, they will say, you have gone crazy, it's all right with our system, we want status quo. So only those people who have extraordinary courage, they care to come forward and say, oh, this is wrong and we want to rectify it. So people who don't have that much courage, they keep behind. But when some people have come forward and they have set examples of courage, and how fortitude they show, and how much of forbearance they show, then you know the excuse of the others is gone. Now they should see that they are also human beings. They have done this, they have achieved this. So why can't I do it? I am also a human being. So now their excuse is, you know, they are without any weight in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah الذي أنزل الكتاب بالحق والميزان. Allah is He who has sent down the book with truth and mizan and the balance. Balance is the symbol for justice. You see, mostly outside the courts, outside the Supreme Court in Islamabad, Pakistan, and High Court in Lahore, we have this picture of a balance. Because balance means justice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the book, the law. What's the purpose of that law? To establish justice. Now, if justice is not established, you go on reading law and get sawab, that's all, what's it? This book was not sent for only reading and reciting and getting sawab. You have to establish it. What's use reading it? What do you gain? لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ Say to them, O people of book, you have no position whatsoever unless you establish Torah and Injil. Then you can come to us, talk to us. يَا أَهْلَ الْقُرْآنِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ الْقُرْآنِ O you people who believe in Quran, you have no standing whatsoever unless you establish Quran. Then pray to us, we shall listen to your prayers. You have thrown Quran on your backs, and you go and pray to us. We are not going to listen to your prayers. These prayers of yours will be thrown into your faces. And this is what is happening today. Daily, Dua Qunut in Masjid Nabi, Masjid Haram both. But to what use? Allah is not listening. Dua-e-Qunut for so long, in 1971. What happened to Pakistan? It was split into two. Allah didn't listen. Did you establish our deen? We gave you Pakistan, we gave you the country, we gave you the freedom. What did you do? So this is it. وَالَّذِينَ يُحَاجُّونَ فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا اسْتُجِيبَ لَهُ حُجَّتُهُمْ دَاحِضَةٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَعَلَيْهِمْ غَضَبٌ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ وَالْمِيزَانِ These words, بِالْحَقِّ وَالْمِيزَانِ Kitab and Mizan, they have appeared twice in Quran together. In this Surah Shura and then Surah Al-Hadith. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ We send down with our messengers the book and the balance so that people should abide by justice. وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ قَرِيبٌ And how can you know maybe that hour has come near? That hour when reckoning will be for each person, you know, what you did, what you were required to do and what you actually did. يَسْتَعْجِرُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا Those who don't believe in the hour and the day of judgment, they want to hasten it. Bring it, Muhammad. You have been threatening us for so long a time. Now bring it. يَسْتَعْجَلُونَ بِهَا يَسْتَعْجَلُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا Because they don't believe in it. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مُشْفِقُونَ مِنْهَا Those who believe in Akhirah, in that as-sa'ah, they are fearful of it. They tremble with the idea that they will have to stand before their Lord. وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ الْحَقِّ And they know this is the truth, that hour will come, and that day of judgment will come. أَلَا إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُمَارُونَ فِي السَّاعَةِ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ Behold those people who have doubts about this hour, they have gone very far off astray. اللَّهُ لَطِيفٌ بِعْبَادِهِ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْقَوِيُّ الْعَزِيزُ Now, if a person, he accepts this mission for his life, I will live for Allah, will die for Allah. I devote myself for the iqamat al-deen, for the establishment of the deen of Allah. Now the idea has come from Satan. What will you eat? What about your family? You are devoting yourself. What will happen to your family, your dependents? Yourself, your children, they need education. You have daughters, you have to get them married. So what has happened to you? You have gone crazy. The answer is here. Allahu latifum bi'ibadihi. Allah is very subtly aware of the needs of His servants. He knows. When I devote myself to Allah, He knows what I need. And He will provide me with it. He has all the authority in His hand. How is it possible? You devote yourself to some big chief, for example, some big landlord. Will he not look after your needs? Allah, the Malikul Mulk, if you devote yourself for Him, He will not take care of you. Even you don't know what you need. He knows what you need. We never knew what is vitamin C and what is vitamin E and what is vitamin A. But these things had been provided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have come to know later on that we needed these things. Allahu latifum bi'ibadi yarzuqu man yasha'a. He gives sustenance to whomsoever He wishes. Wa huwa al-qawiyyul aziz. And He is the strong and mighty. He can provide you. He can give you sustenance. من كان يريد حرص الآخرة نزد له في حرصه. Whosoever aims at the reward of Akhirah. I told you before also. This is the crux of the matter. You want Dunya or Akhirah? If you want Dunya, Allah will give you. Work hard and you will get something. Maybe not everything that you want, but at least, you know, something He will give you. But if you want Akhirah, the hereafter, for that you have to work. Man kana yuridu harsal akhirate. Whosoever decides that he needs and he desires the Akhirah, the reward of Akhirah, nazid lahu fi harse. We shall keep on increasing in his rewards. For man kana yuridu harsal dunya, and whosoever desires the rewards of this world, nutihi minha, we shall give him from this. Okay, you can have a better house, you can have a bigger television set, you can have these things. Be happy with these things. Nutihi minha wa ma lahu fil akhirat min nasib. But for him, then there is no share in the hereafter. There he will be at zero. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَعْذُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. A very important point. These false gods who were associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were worshipped. But none of them gave any deen to those who worshipped them. Has Hubal or Lat or Uzza or Manat, have they given you some law, some rules, some guidance? Has some book been revealed from them? Nothing. It's one-way traffic. You are worshipping and worshipping and worshipping. What are you are getting from them? If you worship Allah, He guides you. Allah has given you this book. Allah has given you the law. Allah has given you the perfect politico-socio-economic system of justice. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَعْذُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. Do they have such associators with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who have ordained for them a religion for which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not allowed? What means this? None. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ فَصْلِ لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ. If the word of final judgment had not passed earlier, final judgment will come on the day of judgment, not here. لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Then everything could have been decided among them at once. وَإِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And for these evildoers, there is a very painful chastisement. تَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا. On that day, on the day of judgment, you will see, O Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the evildoers will be fearful on account of what they had earned. They knew it. what we did in the life of the world, everybody knows. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ بَشِيرًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَهُ. Everybody knows where he stands. So they will be fearful what is going to happen to them. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. On the other hand, those who had believed and who had done good deeds, فِي رَوْضَاتٍ جَنَّاتٍ. They will be in the meadows of the gardens. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاؤُونَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. For them, there will be everything that they will desire. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ. Definitely, this is the greatest bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ الَّذِي يُبَشِّرُ اللَّهُ عِبَادَهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. This is the reward which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given glad tidings to those servants of His who came to believe and did good deeds. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. Say to these people of Makkah and Arabia, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't demand from you any wages, any labor, any reward from the services that I am rendering. I am coming to you, reciting to you these ayat. There were poets in that society. When they recited some poem, they wanted some inam, you know. There should be something. Have I ever asked you for anything? قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَىٰ. One thing I do ask, and that is that you should have regard for the kinship. I am a relative of yours. I am from Bani Hashim. And this is a clan of Quraysh. I am a Qarshi. I am from this very land, Makkah. I am the son of this soil. At least if you don't accept me, if you don't accept my dawah, don't oppose me. Don't call bad names for me. Don't say I am a Majnoon. I am crazy. I am a liar. I am taking a dictation from somebody and then saying that this is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least you should have regard of the relationship which I have with you. وَمَنْ يَقْتَرِفْ حَسَنَةً. And whosoever scores a good deed, if somebody from among you supports me, helps me, نَزِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنًا. We shall increase for him in it goodness, virtues. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Verily, Allah is forgiving and appreciating. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. Do they say that he has forged a lie on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That is, he has composed this Quran himself and he's saying this is being revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنْ يَشَأِ اللَّهُ يَخْتِمْ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. So if Allah wishes, O Muhammad, he can put a seal on your heart, then nothing will come. Because heart is the place where Quran descends. فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. This Quran was revealed to the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If a seal is put, this will finish. Allah can do it. We had this ayah, you know, in Surah Bani Israel. وَلَإِنْ شَيْنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ. If you wish, we can take away from you the revelation we have already given you. And here it is being said, that if we wish, we can put a seal on your heart. وَيَمْحُ اللَّهُ الْبَاطِلِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blots out the falsehood. وَيُحِقُّ الْحَقَّ بِكَلِمَاتِهِ. And He proves the truth to be true with His commands, His words. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Verily, He knows what is there in the hearts and minds of the people. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنِ عِبَادِهِ. And He is who accepts the repentance from His bondsmen and servants. وَيَعْفُ عَنِ السَّيِّئَاتِ. And He pardons evil deeds. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Very well knows what you are doing. وَيَسْتَجِيبُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And He answers the prayers of those who believe and who do good deeds. وَيَزِيدُهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Whatever they want, ask for, I give them. And I add to it from my own bounty. وَالْكَافِرُونَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ. As for those disbelievers who are rejecting this, for them is a severe chastisement. وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ رِزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had expanded the sustenance for the people in this world, plenty of everything for everybody. لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ Then they would have revolted and rebelled in this land. Now they have to somehow, sometime they have to ask me, Oh Allah, give me food. Oh Allah, give me this. But had we provided them everything in plenty, nobody would have ever turned his face towards us. لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَاكِ يُنَزِّلُ بِقَدْرِ مَا يَشَاءُ Nay, he sends with estimates and measure whatever he wishes. إِنَّهُ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ Verily, he is with his servants, خَبِير, he is aware of their conditions and he is seeing them. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا قَنَطُوا And he is Allah, who sends down the rain after they become despaired, drought. Rain has not come. Our fields will remain barren. But then rain comes. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا قَنَطُوا Pointed, despaired. But then Allah sends down rain. وَيَنْشُرُ رَحْمَتَهُ And He spreads His mercy. وَهُوَ الْوَلِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ And He is the protector and praiseworthy. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Among His signs are the creation of heaven and earth. وَمَا بَصَّ فِيهِمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ And the moving creatures which He has spread in both. In the heavens also, the malaika, the angels, they are moving about. On the earth, all types of animals, then human beings. وَبَصَّ فِيهِمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ جَمْعِهِمْ إِذَا يَشَاءُ قَدِيرٌ Whosoever has spread them, he can collect them also. One day will come, he will gather them all, and he is powerful over it. وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ Whatever affliction or misfortune comes upon you, it is due to what your own hands have earned. وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٌ And he pardons also a lot of it. Lot of your mistakes and sins, Allah pardons. But some of these things, you know, in this very world, you are given some punishment. وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُعْجِزِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ You cannot defeat us, defeat Allah in the land, in the earth. وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ Nor there is for you any protector or helper besides Allah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ الْجَوَارِ فِي الْبَحْرِ كَالْعَلَامِ From his signs is another one. The ships like mountains and they are sailing upon the seas. إِنْ يَشَى يُسْكِنِ الْرِيحَ If Allah decides, He can cause the wind to stop. You know, those were the days when, you know, the steamships were not there and now we have very big ships. But when only the wind was the means and بادبانی کشتیا جب ہوتی تھی تو اس میں کہا وَإِنْ يَشَى يُسْكِنِ الْرِيحِ If he likes, he can cause the wind to stop. فَيَضْلَلْنَا رَوَاكِدَ عَلَىٰ ظَهْرِ So your boats and ships would stand motionless on the surface of water. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ And this are the signs for those people who are persevering and grateful. أَوْ يُوبِقُهُنَّ بِمَا كَسَبُوا Or he can drown them, drown the ships due to what they have earned. وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ But he pardons a lot. وَيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا So that people who argue and dispute our revelations, they will come to know مَا لَهُم مِّن مَحِيص They will have no escape. When you know the ship drowns, no escape. Now, 8 آيات are coming and they are Again, very important regarding the axis of this surah. Iqamatuddin. The struggle for Iqamatuddin. Now, whosoever makes a decision, he devotes himself for the struggle. There are certain qualities that he should produce in him. Some characteristics of character. Everybody cannot do. You have to qualify first. So, what are those qualities? You can count. Number one. فَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَمَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Whatsoever you are given in this world, take it that it is only a means of living in this world. It's not the real wealth. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. What is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is much better and lasting for those who believe in Allah. You know, this world should become small in their eyes. It should not be the objective of human beings to get this world. No, it's very small. Allah has made me very great. Allah bore all the angels before me. What is this world for me? إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا خُلِقَتْ لَكُمْ. There is a hadith. This world has been created for you. And you have been created. وَأَنْتُمْ خُلِقْتُمْ لِلْآخِرَةِ. You have been created for Akhirah. This world is nothing. This is for you already. He has subjected to you everything which is here. Serving you. The sun, the moon, the stars, everything. So, number one is that one should understand the importance of this worldly wealth should diminish in his eyes. And he should fix his gaze on the blessings of Akhirah. Number two, وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. They should put their trust wholly and solely in Allah. Not, I can do it. No, no. My trust is in only Allah. I can try. But the result will be in the hands of Allah. I can't do anything without His support, without His help. Tawakkul totally on Allah. Do whatever you can. Don't sit down. Do whatever you can. But your trust should not be in the material means that you have gathered or your own intelligence. No. Trust in God. Number three. وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِسْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ. And those who shun the heinous sins and indecencies. The bigger crimes. There are smaller crimes also. Don't worry for them. Allah will wash them off. Bigger crimes. Shirk. Killing anybody. Adultery. Telling a lie. These are the things, biggest crimes. If you shun these bigger crimes and the indecencies, fahsha, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep on washing your smaller crimes. This subject has been repeated in the Quran thrice. And this is very important. There are, you might have seen certain people who become very conscious of the small things, trivial things. But if you look deep into their lives, they are very cautious of the trivial things, but the bigger sins, they are continuing. They are involved in riba, the biggest haram in Islam. But for smaller things, they are fighting with each other. This is a special character, traditional religious people. But here what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us? You take care of the bigger things, the bigger crimes, the bigger muharramat, and I'll wash off your smaller crimes. This is in Surah An-Nisa, and then finally in Surah An-Najm, in the 27th part of Quran. Number four, وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. And when they become angry, they pardon and forgive. For a da'i, it is very essential. If you say, I have to take the revenge, he has done this thing all to me, I must give him the reply in the same coin, well then you are not a da'i. For da'is, it is necessary. Take verbal persecution. And you just take them patiently. And forgive people. As you have heard so many times, the prayer of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma ghfir qawmi. Allahumma ihdi qawmi. Innahum la ya'lamun. Oh my Lord, just give guidance to these people of mine. Whatever they are doing, they don't know what they are doing. They are stoning me. They are throwing stones on me. But oh Allah, they don't know what they are doing. So give them the guidance. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوا هُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. Number 5. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ. Those who respond to the call of their Lord. And what is the call of the Lord? In this surah, only one call of the Lord has come. أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. Did you have any iqabatu salat here? Up till now, not. Now it will come. But up till now, not. The only call is an aqimuddin. The only thing forbidden, wala tatafarraqu fi. Regarding deen and establishment of deen, you shouldn't differ. But regarding the details of sharia, you can have differences of opinion. No harm. Fiqh Hanafi and fiqh Maliki and so on, no harm. But deen is the same. And the struggle of iqamatuddin, that should be joint. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ. They say, لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ. We are present. I devote myself to the struggle of establishment of your deen. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept me. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ. Now comes an established prayer. To have a direct contact and strong contact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this 5 times prayers a day is most essential. Because in this worldly business you get lost. You just forget. You have to renew your pledge. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. A very beautiful couplet of Hafiz Jalandhari. Sarkashi ne kar diye dhundle nuqush-e bandagi. The arrogance within me have made the marks of my bondsmanhood. There were the marks that I am the bondman of Allah. But due to arrogance, they have been washed off. Aao sajde mein gire, lohe jabi taza kare. Let us prostrate before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have that imprint of the bondsmanship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala renewed on our foreheads. Aao sajde mein gire, lohe jabi taza kare. وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ. Number 7. And they have to decide their matters by mutual consultation. No authoritarianism. Nobody should say that I am the total wisdom and total knowledge. No, no. You have to consult with each other. The party affairs should be done by mutual consultation. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And whatever we have given to them, they spent. For every struggle, you need money. To establish the deen of Allah, you need money. To go to war for the cause of Allah, you need money. For weapons, for rations, everything. For the propagation, you need money. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. These 3 ayat on this subject, again let me say, are the most profound ayat. Ayat 13, 14, 15, then Ayat 36, 37, 38. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُهُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. But now something different is coming. And those whom, if there is something wrong done to them, they take revenge. This is contrary to what we have been talking before. In Surah Hamim Sajda, idfa billati ahsan. You have to forgive. But here, because this is the surah of Iqamatuddin. Iqamatuddin means Iqamat of justice, establishment of justice. And that justice requires that if something wrong is done to somebody, he can take revenge. وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقِصَاصِ حَيَاتٌ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. And their system will be established. There will be a system of qisas, revenge. If somebody has murdered somebody, he should lose his life. Or be only the wali of the person who was murdered. He can pardon him, nobody else. No head of the state has the power or authority to pardon him. So, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُ الْبَغْيُهُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. There's nothing bad in it. وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. And the reward of an evil thing is an evil thing equal to it. Don't go beyond it. What injury he has given to you, the same you can give to your to other person, not more than that. فَمَنْ أَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ. Now persuasion. But whosoever pardons and makes peace, فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. His reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily he doesn't like and love the evildoers. وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ. Anyhow, whosoever takes revenge after he was wronged, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. There is no way of blame to them. You can't say that you have done something wrong. No, it is his right. If he demands revenge, it is his right. وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ. The blame is for those الَّذِينَ يَظْلِمُونَ النَّاسِ, who oppress mankind. وَيَبْغُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. And they rebel in the earth wrongly. They become the exploiters. They become the oppressors. We are high up, you are low. We are Brahmins. You are Shudra. Who are you? You can't even hear the words of scriptures. If by chance a word of the Hindu scriptures passes into the ear of a Shudra, you know, molten lead will be thrown in the ear and make him deaf. Oh, no. All human beings by birth are equal. No higher, no lower. No superior, no inferior. No high, no low. So this injustices. On the basis of the color of the skin, on the basis of races, on the basis of professions. It's a menial profession, you know. Any labor, it should be respectful. He's working. And you know, whosoever earns his livelihood by working by hand, the Prophet had said, he is the best earner. So what's with the hand? إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَظْلِمُونَ النَّاسَ وَيَبْغُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. The blame is to those who oppress the people and they rebel in the land without any right. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. For them, there is a very painful chastisement. إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ. In the end again. But whosoever takes it patiently and forgives. إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عَظْمِ الْأُمُورِ. Now this is of very high level. This is a very strong character is needed for this. To forgive, then you can take the revenge. If you can't take the revenge, well, what you can do? Nothing. But if you can take the revenge, and then you don't, and you pardon, and you forgive, and you make peace, it's of a very high character. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. And whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent astray, you won't find for him, after him, any protector. وَتَرَى الظَّالِمِينَ لَمَّا رَعَوُ الْعَذَابِ. And you will see these evildoers. When they will see the chastisement before their eyes, يَخُولُونَ هَلْ إِلَىٰ مَرَدٍ مِّنْ سَبِيلٍ. They will say, is there any way to give back? وَتَرَاهُمْ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا. You will see them. They will be presented to the fire. This is the hell and they are standing. خَاشِعِينَ مِنَ الظُّلِّ. And they will be humbled with disgrace. يَنْظُرُونَ مِنْ طَرْفٍ خَفِيٍّ. They will only be having a stealthy glance, seeing from the corner. Can't lift their eyes. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And then those who had believed, they would say, إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Verily, the real losers are those who made themselves the losers, and not only themselves, also their families. Because their families are following them. They were going on the same road. So they have brought them also to the greatest loss. أَلَا إِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ فِي عَذَابٍ مُقِيمٍ. Behold, these evildoers will be in a lasting chastisement. وَمَا كَانَ لَهُمْ مِنْ أَوْلِيَا And they will not have any protectors. يَنْصُرُونَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ Who will be able to help them besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يُذِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent astray, he will not find any way for him. Now the two ayat again of the same importance. 3 plus 3 and now 2. استجيبوا لربكم. Say yes to the call of Allah. Say labbaik to the call of Allah. Answer the call of your Lord. And what is the call? أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. All the other things are subservient to this. The call basically is in ayah number 13. شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. استجيبوا لربكم. Respond positively to the call of your Lord. من قبل أن يأتي يوما. Before that time, that day comes, لا مرد له من الله. That time comes by the command of Allah, which will not be able to be turned back. It can mean your death, the day of your death. When that comes, it won't go back. And the hour for the whole world. ما لكم من ملجأ يومئذ. That day you will not have any refuge. وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ نَكِيرٍ And there will not be possible any denial from your side that we didn't do it. Oh, okay. اِقْرَا كِتَابَكَ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا And as I said, one button pushed and the whole film of his whole life will come. It will start. Today we can understand these things very easily. فَإِنْ عَرَضُوا But then, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, If they don't call back, don't respond to your call, don't say labbaik to Allah. فَإِنْ عَرَضُوا If they turn away, فَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَفِيظًا So we have not sent you over guard. You are not responsible. إِنْ عَلَيْكَ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ There's no responsibility on you except the conveying of the message. وَإِنَّا إِذَا أَذَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنَّا رَحْمَةً And the strange thing is that when we make man taste our mercy, فَرِحَ بِهَا He rejoices with it. وَإِنْ تُصِبْهُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ And if something bad comes to them, بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ Due to what their own hands have sent forward, فَإِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ كَفُورٌ Then this man becomes totally ungrateful. لِلَّهِ مُلْكِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ The concluding ayat of this surah, very profound. لِلَّهِ مُلْكِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ To Allah belongs the sovereignty and kingdom of the heavens and the earth. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ He creates whatever He likes. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا He gives only daughters to whom He wishes. وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذَّكُورَ And to whom he wishes, he gives sons only, no daughter. أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا Or he mingles them males and females, daughters and sons both. وَيَجَعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا And he makes whomsoever he likes barren, no son, no daughter. Having gone to all the corners of the world, all treatments, no way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given you. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ قَدِيرٌ Verily, He is all-knowing, all-powerful. وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ Now is coming, you know, the subject of wahi. وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهِ The position of man is not such that Allah should talk to him. Allah can talk to him. Allah is all-powerful, but Allah is very high, you are very low. It's not for you that Allah should talk to you directly. Illa wahyan. There are three ways of communication, divine communication to human beings. Number one, wahyan. direct inspiration into the heart of the people. أَوْ مِنْ وَرَائِ حِجَاب or from behind a curtain, just as Allah talked to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. أَوْ يُرْسِلَ رَسُولًا number three, or he sends a messenger, an angel, فَيُوْحِيَ بِإِذْنِهِ مَا يَشَاءَ and then he reveals to that person whatever Allah desires. So three modes, direct wahi of Allah, direct inspiration, we call it inspiration. And we have another words also, ilham, ilqa. Something comes to your mind, suddenly, you don't know. The sixth sense, the intuition. You give them different names, something has come to you. And you are yourself surprised. I was not thinking about it. I had not gathered the arguments for and against and weighed them against each other. No, it has come to my mind. So this ilqa, ilham, these things are direct inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The number two is Allah speaks from behind a curtain as he spoke to Moses. And three is, and Allah sends an angel as a messenger and he then reveals to the human messenger whatever Allah wishes. So this wahi is the third form of wahi, this Quran. وَكَذَلِكَ now this word كَذَلِكَ appears for the third time. Twice we had in the very beginning. كَذَلِكَ يُوحِي إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لِتُنْذِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَى وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا كَذَلِكَ in this way, O Muhammad, in this third way, O Muhammad, we have revealed down and sent down this book to you. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا now this wahi is called ruh, I have told you. The angel is Ruh, or Ruhul Quds, Ruhul Amin. The Ruh, the spirit of Muhammad is Ruh. And the communication between the angel and the spirit, human spirit, is Ruh. Ruham min Amrina, from our command. This is from Alame Amr. These three things belong to Alame Amr. Now all people can't understand this. We have discussed these things many a times during this month. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِيمَ الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ O Muhammad, you never knew what is book and what is iman. You were born to an illiterate people. You were yourself unlettered one. There was no book with your family, your nation, your people. You never learned reading and writing. You never knew what is the book, Allah book, and what's iman. مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِيمَ الْكِتَابَ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ Very important ayah. Even Muhammad got iman from Quran. Before the revelation of Quran, O Muhammad, you never knew what is book and what is iman. وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا We have made this Quran the light. نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا And we guide with this whomsoever we like from our servants. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمِ And now that Quran has come to you, and your spirit is fully lightened by this light of Quran, now you will lead the people to the straight path. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي now, because you have this Quran. This Quran has permeated each and every cell of your existence. You are actually Quran. As Hazrat Aisha said, when you know people went to her, رضي الله تعالى عنها, and they said, tell us something about the seerah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And she retorted, don't you read Quran? They said, Ummul Mumineen, we read Quran very well, but we are asking for seerah. And then she replied, Kana khulukul Quran. His character is Quran, his seerah is Quran. He was Quran in the form of a human flesh and bone, Quran itself. So now you can lead people to the right path. Sirati Allahi allazi lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. And what is meant by right path? Right of the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To whom belong whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. Ala ilallahi tasirul umur. Behold, to Allah will be returned all the matters for the final judgment. Everything will be presented before Him on the day of judgment. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات وذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.